This last slide shows a complete set of four stereoisomers. We have pairs of diastereomers, which are not mirror images of each other, but there's also a couple of pairs of enantiomers in which the molecules are. We've got two chiral centers in these molecules. They are all 2,3-dihydroxybutanoic acid. They would be white solids that would look a lot alike. But the ones that are diastereomers would have different properties that allow them to be separated. Oftentimes when molecules are synthesized and chiral carbons are created, you will get equal amounts of all of these. Oftentimes you get equal amounts of two enantiomers, and if you have more than one chiral carbon, you may have the capability of getting some of all of these. On other occasions, only one particular stereoisomer may form in a reaction. And oftentimes those are valuable reactions because of all the different properties that these different stereoisomers can have. Generally, there's one particular isomer that has some desirable properties or ones we're interested in. So a lot of methods in chemistry strive to synthesize molecules that have one particular configuration at every carbon that has chirality. And that can sometimes be quite a challenge. It's worth studying this slide. You can see that they've labeled carbons 2 and 3 as either being R or S in all four of these. They've also indicated the polarimetry readings, the amount of rotation of light, of plane polarized light. And you can see that the top two that are enantiomers, they do have equal but opposite rotations, as do the bottom set of enantiomers, positive 17.8, negative 17.8. What's also useful to know is that the carbons that are R in one isomer are going to be S in its enantiomer, and vice versa. So at the top, we've got 2R3R, meaning the configuration at carbon 2 is R, and it's also that as at carbon 3. So it's necessarily going to be true that its enantiomer reverses both of those, 2s, 3s. The other set of enantiomers, notice that we've got in each of them one R configuration and one S. It's R at carbon 2 here in the bottom left corner, S at carbon 3, and both of those chiralities are reversed in its enantiomer. The ones labeled as diastereomers, and you can see there are several pairs of those we could pick out. They have common chirality at one carbon, but opposite configuration at the other. So that means they are partially superimposable on their mirror image, but not completely. If they are not superimposable at all, then we can say they're enantiomers. It's worth your time to convince yourself that these are labeled correctly as far as R and S go. With the wedges and dashes, we can figure out and then confirm those chiralities. So you can not only make sure this figure is correct, but you can get some practice on your own in assigning either R or S. And there are a couple of worksheets, not to mention the exercises from Chapter 7, which will give you some more practice in doing that. And one of the worksheets in particular relates structures that are wedge and dash to ones that are Fischer projections, which again, another common way of relating these molecules.